The term cholo refers to a style of dress and to the young Chicanos who wear it. In the eyes of some law enforcement groups, wearing the clothes is synonymous with gang membership, but to young people, the style is an affirmation of their culture.
Some of our nephews and cousins are cholos, but they're not bad cholos. I mean, it's just like every race. You have some good and some bad. I know when I was a girl, they judged me by the company you keep, and it was against school rules to wear those tight skirts, and you couldn't wear any dangly jewelry, and you couldn't speak Spanish. And that's your basic right there, to speak your own tongue. And just because I did wear a tight skirt or I wore earrings, it didn't make me bad. But at that time, you were bad. You were expelled from school. My children know so many different races and different people. And they've been involved in all kinds of activities since they were small. And some of the kids have had trouble, and they've gone another way. But not because of what club they were in or what clothes they were. They just went that way.
I heard about New Style for a long time, ever since I was a little kid, and I wanted to always get in a car club, and I always thought New Style, you have a lot of friends and a lot of nice cars, some of the best cars.
Actually, joining a lowrider car club never made anyone go the wrong way. Although most lowriders aren't club members, the clubs enjoy a special status. They are highly visible through their involvement in community activities, and some of the best cars carry the club plaques. You don't have to be Chicano to join, just serious about cars.
I grew up with Chicanos all my life, so they're all my friends, and I'm not a prejudiced person, and I like to make friends with everybody.
This is Jose's car!
Just being serious about lowriding isn't quite enough. Cars must pass strict inspection before they're allowed to show the car insignia on the boulevard. Each club has its own standards. For the Dukes, 1953 was the last of the good years. If you have the ability or the money, the car can serve as the canvas on which you express yourself. But many young people without cars still incorporate the image of the lowrider into their art, whether it is on paper or on cloth.
I was at like a little lowrider, and I seen some dude with the Virgin Mary on the back of his shirt. So I said, hey, you know, that's a great idea, hitting up on shirts, you know, everybody can see your art, you know, you walk outside, you get something on your back.
In Malo's t-shirts, you'll find references to prison life and street graffiti. A mixture of Mexican history and Catholicism, with images of death and the forces of evil.
It's not that I like the devil or anything, but I like the way of it's mad, you know, don't mess with me, you know. One time I was on the bus, one time some lady said, oh, you shouldn't wear that on your back. Why don't you put Jesus or something? I said, it's not that, it's the art, you know, the way it looks, you know. People like it and I like it, so I wear it.
But being special often means that you get singled out.
Sometimes they drink up, make a lot of noise in front of people's houses, but everybody does that. I mean, even the high riders are over there partying, you know. Just like us low riders, people are people, everybody's the same.
On the surface, there may be a difference between the people who can afford low riders and the kids on the street, but you have to look deeper.
They got their car and they can go anywhere they want to, and they got the money, I guess, you know. The homeboys, they just stroll around, you know, go buy up, you know, kick back. Mm-hmm. They ain't got no ride, right?
Yeah.
But still, you know, it ain't nothing, you know? There's a lot of people that don't have rides. Yeah. I mean, the ride ain't the main thing, you know? I don't
think it's what you were, right?
Yes, I think that's what it is. Uh-huh. I mean, you know, not every lowrider could draw.
So you got something some other people don't?
Right, just like they got their ride, you know? Got something different, too. You know? Oh, baby, so much joy.
It's not just Malo. There is a whole generation of artists whose roots are in their community. whose art is as real as the streets that it comes from. These images are from Arte del Barrio, the art of the community, a special publication of Lowrider magazine. Whether it's a mural, a drawing, a car panel, or a tattoo, art inspires other art, and the process continues. But before we finish, a few final thoughts and images.
What I like to see in lowriders themselves is their creativity. They have a lot to offer to society, a lot to offer to the world, a lot to offer to the church. They're full of life, they're full of ideas, they're full of energy.
Throughout the barrios de Aztlán, witness the expression of the Chicano pride wave. Simón Queyes, la movida chicana, la onda de Aztlán, la onda bajita empieza. ¿Y estás tú, are you part de la onda? Cholas, cholos, gangas, pintos y veteranos, all proud y firme. Take a stand, párense, pleitos, gang warfare divides us, raza.
Chicana empieza. Baggies, counties, dickies, friscos, painters, Pendletons, zoot suits, full of style with a smile and dignity. Take a stand, párense. La migra raids send our gente back across a border that we never even crossed. It crossed us, raza.
Just the way that you are.
This is your invitation, for we stand for pride, unity, dignity, and respect. And at the heart of it all, al mero corazón is love, el amor eterno. Pues que pues, are you parte de la onda?
Cubo.
Means a lot to me, something that I was brought up with that, you know, it's me, you know, it's not really, it really means something, it was just me, you know, I'm that.
Funding for this program was provided by a grant from the Corporation for Public Broadcasting.